Hi, my name is Jon Wilker. I study mussels. So I got into science simply because I've always found it to be interesting. I've always wanted to understand how things work and how you can make new things. Chemistry for me has actually turned out to be a really good avenue for that because you can get down to a very fundamental level to just understand how the world works.
John is a chemist at Purdue University in Indiana. His research lab investigates the adhesive qualities of marine organisms like oysters and mussels.
So we've been interested in studying mussels because they make interesting materials. So what mussels will do is they'll find a nice rock that they like and they'll attach themselves to the surface. And in doing this, they produce adhesive. They make a glue to stick. And it's kind of interesting. There's a lot of applications you might be able to think of for a biologically produced adhesive, something that can set in a wet environment and something that makes really strong bonds to the surface. You can imagine, say, for instance, a surgical adhesive or a dental adhesive. In a typical experiment, what we'll do is develop a new coating. We'll take a bunch of metal plates, test plates. We'll coat them all. Typically, we just paint them on, roll them on, whatever. And then we'll put them in seawater. And as we have them in seawater, then we'll add the animals on top. We'll let them put their adhesive if they choose to. And they actually have some preference as to when they put the adhesive down and when they don't. And then after they put the adhesive down, we'll cut off the animal. And then with each adhesive, there's individual plaques, the little discs of the glue, and then the threads that come out. What we'll do is we'll put it on the Instron machine, we'll clamp onto the threads, pull that up, and then we'll know how strong the adhesive is. So this morning, we have a chance to do one of the really fun aspects of the job. We're gonna go out and do a little bit of field work.
It's gonna be cold.
Another thing we're also trying to do is actually prevent the adhesion. So for instance, can we develop anti-fouling surfaces for ship hulls? If you could prevent the fouling of barnacles and mussels and various types of algae onto ships, that would be great because then if you reduce, say, the drag of a ship going through water, you'll need less fuel. You're burning less fuel, so you're putting a lot less pollution in the air, so less CO2.
In the lab or in the classroom, John likes to share his passion for science.
I like teaching the classes. But another aspect of it is actually working with the graduate students in the lab and teaching them how to do research and mentoring them. The graduate students are completely essential to running the lab. And actually, when you're in my position and you're the professor, you get in the lab a little bit occasionally and you talk to the graduate students and you help maybe guide them in their projects. But each student has their own independent project. A lot of the science is more a very gradual progression, and you're building up knowledge and you're building up pictures to the point when you might finally have an understanding that you're happy with.
As part of their research, John and his team are doing experiments that someday may save lives.
So we have a lot of different projects going on in our research lab now, all, to me at least, I think are really exciting. One project, we're trying to develop new compounds to actually prevent cancer, not cure cancer, but prevent it from happening in the first place. We work really hard. We can't sugarcoat it and say, you work 30, 40 hours a week and you'll be fine, because that's really not the case, especially nowadays. Expectations are quite high. However, it's really rewarding. You know, one of the benefits, for instance, is when you start up your own lab, you get to work on whatever you want. After we characterize the adhesive from the animals, we then try to design synthetic versions of the adhesive. So basically preserving some of the interesting adhesive chemistry, but at the same time, dialing in a little bit of flexibility into the system so we can adapt the properties of material to different applications. So in order to support the research in our lab, we need money for that. And in order to get money, we write a lot of proposals to the federal funding agencies. And this is a drawer showing an example of just some of the proposals we've written over recent years. Some of these have been successful, a lot of them have not. And okay, let's just not think about that anymore and close this for now.
John loves science and puts a lot into it, but he also enjoys his free time.
I like to jog a little bit. That's also something that relaxes me, keeps me in somewhat decent shape, and I feel good after that. And there too, you can work through some things from research, maybe in your mind, or maybe even use it to try and step back and get away from the research a little bit. And so I kind of like that. And obviously scuba diving is sort of a constant, somewhat research related, but it's mostly a hobby, although it's the hobby that got me into this research area.
Hey, that was fun and really cold.
Another thing that's kind of fun lately, I've been learning how to race cars. Excellent, cool, so I'll see you at the track. Sometimes you get under the car and you're working on it, and that can be kind of relaxing and therapeutic. One of the nice things about this job is we get to travel a lot. So sometimes that's to conferences and far-flung places, and sometimes the traveling can be in nice places that you might want to go to. So for instance, in my case, recently I went to a conference in Australia, and so of course, while I was there, we had to get the dive gear and go in and explore the Great Barrier Reef and look for some new research topics and research ideas. You get to decide what you want to work on. Just do something that looks really, really cool. You think that science is great? That's what you should do. And that's actually one of the best things about this, I think, is that you can just find some cool science and go out and do it. So it's fun.